Hello, hello guys. Welcome to a new video session. Okay, I'm Teacher Luigi and I'm really, really glad for you to join us in these classes that we are recording for you every Monday and Thursday. Okay, welcome guys one more time. And okay, so we have to cover today some important topics. For example, we're going to start with just like wrapping up what defining and non-defining relative sentence are. Okay, just I know that we have seen this like through two sessions, but I think today is going to be really, really clear. Okay, second point that we're going to do, we're going to ask for and make recommendations. Okay, very, very important topic as well. Okay, we're going to in the third topic we're going to write about writing skills. Okay, in this time we're going to focus on paragraphing. Why is paragraphing important? Okay, I'll tell you. I have told you in the classroom, but I think it's necessary for you to acquire this sense of writing because paragraphing is really, really important in English-speaking countries, guys. Okay, and also, guys, finally, we're going to write an email about a place and its culture. We're going to talk about Valparaíso in Chile, which is really, really cool. And okay, guys, so let's join me and have fun. Okay, thank you. Okay, guys, let's start this lesson by showing you the National Museum of Anthropology in Mexico City, guys, which is one of the most important ones, okay, here in our country, okay. And then we have very, very specific pieces of art, okay, just like historic art, very, very nice, okay. So let me show you guys, okay, look, okay, very nice images, okay. So this is the official website, guys, okay, look, okay, what is there? Okay, so one of the stars of the museum, guys, in this case, we have the sunstone or the stone of the sun as well. Well, both ways are correct. Or just like we have, okay, here, La Piedra del Sol, okay, or the Aztec calendar. Okay, remember, it is known in two ways, the sunstone or the Aztec calendar, guys, okay, here, okay, which is kind of beautiful, guys, yes, okay. In order for you to have a very, very specific idea of what is this, guys, what size is this, okay, we have here some pictures, okay, just like it's just like really, really big, okay. You can see here, guys, that for example, okay, here. Okay, before we start with the listening, guys, okay, let me show you these pictures I was telling you at the beginning of the session that we have here beautiful pictures of the pyramid of the feather serpent, okay, here. Okay, remember this part of the pyramid is in the museum, okay, it's not in Teotihuacan, just like in the museum, okay. Here we have Quetzalcoatl here, and it's here we have a someone just like taking pictures. It says Pyramid of the Feathered Serpent from Teotihuacan in the National Museum of Anthropology in Mexico City. Okay, just I was telling you that I cried when I was there because I don't know, it's really, really impressive, guys. Okay, so we're going to talk about the museum, okay, which is in Mexico City in Chapultepec. You know that, okay? And okay, what we have to do, guys? Okay, we have to do this exercise. Listen to people talking about the same tourist attraction. What do they agree about and what do they disagree about? Okay, so we're going to listen and we're going to answer these questions. Okay, okay, guys, I'm not going to show you the script because it's really, really, this listening is really easy, guys. Okay, so just pay attention and that's it. Okay, ready? Okay, listen.
One. The next place you might like to go if the weather isn't great is the Anthropology Museum, which is all about the native people of Mexico and Central America. Now, I highly recommend this place because it's such a beautifully designed museum. There is simply so much to see. you won't want to miss the Stone of the Sun, which is a large stone Aztec calendar and one of the most famous sites in Mexico. There are some amazing examples of Olmec heads, the biggest statues of heads you will probably ever see, and lots of other attractions that are well worth experiencing. Make sure to plan your visit, though. You can easily spend all day there, which will appeal to the historians among you. But I have to say, I got tired after about 3 hours. One more thing. I would recommend hiring a tour guide who won't charge much, but will make the visit much more informative. Right, the next rainy day idea is...
2. Guadalupe?
Hey!
You've been to the Anthropology Museum, haven't you?
Yes, I've been a couple of times. Why?
We have visitors coming next week, and I'd like to take them there. Is it any good?
Oh, it's great. You'll love it.
What is there to do?
All sorts of things. I don't normally like museums and that sort of thing, but there's a lot to see there.
Like what?
They have the Stone of the Sun there.
What's that?
You know, the Aztec calendar. You've probably seen copies around the city.
Oh, yeah, I know what you're talking about. And it's in Chapultepec Park, right?
Yes, not far from the center, but it's worth getting there when it opens. If you want, I'll send you a link with directions.
I'm sure I'll find it, no problem. Did you pay for a tour guide?
No, I wouldn't bother if I were you. That's probably pretty expensive. I'd buy a guidebook instead, which you can take home with you.
Great. Well, thanks for that. Any other tips?
Take an umbrella if it rains, because there are a lot of outdoor spaces with things to see in the gardens.
Right. I'll keep my fingers crossed for sun.
Okay, guys, I told you that it was really easy. It was really, really easy to identify and to follow the listening, guys, okay? So, okay, now, remember, guys, if you need to listen to it one more time, just pause the video and rewind the video, and that's it, guys, okay? Okay, guys, so let's do this exercise, okay? So, right away to show you the first answer, okay? It says one more time, listen to people talking about the same tourist attraction. What do they agree about? Okay, so the things that they agreed about was these guys. Okay, they agree that the Anthropology Museum is a great place to visit and that you should not miss the Stone of the Sun. Remember, guys, okay, I was just like searching, guys, and also this is the name, the Stone of the Sun, also is known just like the Sun Stone as well. Okay, or you know that is the La Piedra del Sol or El Calendario Azteca, the Aztec calendar as well. Okay, okay, guys, now, second question, what do they disagree about? Yes, can you tell me? Right, yes, that's true, guys. Okay, they disagree about the benefit of paying for a tour guide. Okay, remember the first first speaker said that it was a very good idea to hire a tour guide because it is a very noticeable and a very good experience. But the lady in the second listening, she said that it was not necessary because it was really expensive. Okay, in my opinion, guys, it is not so expensive, but okay, guys, okay? So if you can go there, just like, it's up to you guys, okay? Okay, ready? Okay, nice. Okay, now let's go to the next exercise, okay? It says here, let me zoom it for you guys. Look at the useful language box. Are the expressions more likely to be said by a friend? So we have to write an F. Or a TV presenter? We have to write TV. Or both? We both, remember? Okay, friend and a TV presenter. Okay, guys, now let me show you the useful language box, guys. Okay. And you know this, guys. because it's kind of easy for you because you know this. Okay, remember, asking for recommendations. In this case, guys, we are talking about recommendations about the museum itself, okay? So asking for recommendation. Is it worth watching? Is it worth seeing? Is it worth visiting? Is it worth reading? Okay, in this case, guys, is it worth watching? Remember this kind of sentence, okay, is vale la pena? Vale la pena verlo? Vale la pena ir? Vale la pena leerlo? Okay, it is worth watching. Okay, it is worth visiting, etc. Okay, now, what do you think or what do you think about? That's in past tense. Or just like very, very informal, is it any good? Okay, that's it. Or was it any good, etc. Okay, okay, so that's the first part. Now, the second part. Making recommendations. You have to go. I'll send you the link. You won't want to miss this. You won't want to miss this. It's worth watching. It's highly recommended. Okay, I mean, the thing is well worth seeing. The museum is well worth seeing. The museum is a must see. Must see, okay, you shouldn't miss it, okay? You have to go there, okay? If you go to Mexico City, you have to go there. It's a must see, okay? Questions about that, guys? Hopefully not, okay? And let's see the third part. Showing reservation. It was okay, I suppose. It was all right, I suppose. Remember, guys, I suppose just like, oh, well, I think so. Yeah, maybe. Okay, remember, that's it, okay? Yes, I guess, I suppose, I guess, okay? The same thing, okay? Now, I wouldn't bother if I were you. I wouldn't bother if I were you. No, don't go. I wouldn't bother if I were you because it's not worth it. It's not worth it, just like that, okay? Yeah, no problem. Okay, I didn't think it was great. Yeah, remember, we're showing reservation, okay? You might like it if you have nothing else to do, okay? Now, if not, just go anywhere else, okay? Don't go there. It's just like this kind of sentence, okay? You might like it if you have nothing else to do. If you enjoy it, you love, okay? That's it. Okay, that's a strongly suggestion, okay? It's appeal to anyone who enjoys appeal, okay? Just like, okay? It'll appeal to anyone who enjoys, okay? For example, the museum, okay, I think it'll appeal to anyone who enjoys history, who enjoys culture, etc., etc. I don't normally like, but, okay, I would recommend it to people who, okay, and then we can just like, remember reservation, okay, it's not no or yes, okay, just like that, okay? Okay, guys, now, just like expressions, guys, we are going to do exercise number two, listen to people talking, no, sorry, number three, look at the useful language box. Are there expressions more likely to be said by a friend or a TV presenter or both, okay? Okay, pause the video and just like write next to the sentence, okay, what you think. For example, guys, let's do one as an example. Okay, the expression, is it worth watching? Okay, who is more likely to say that? To say that, just like a friend or a TV presenter or both? I think a friend, I think a TV presenter or both. Yeah, yeah, I would write both, guys, okay? Yeah. Because it's a common expression, okay? Okay, so pause the video and do the rest, please. Ready, guys? Okay, let's do activity three. Okay, asking for recommendations. Is it worth watching? Is it worth seeing? Is it worth visiting? Is it worth reading? Okay, so it was said by both. Yeah, a friend or a TV presenter. Yeah, it's not like a normal expression, okay? Now, next one. What do you think about was said by both as well, okay? Is it any good? Just like this is more informal, guys. So like it was, I mean, just like, it's just like more common. It's like commonly said by a friend. Now, making recommendations. You have to go. Yeah, that's very informal, guys. You're like a friend. You're like a friend's advice. Now, I'll send you the link. Okay? So, very, very good. A friend. Okay? Yeah, because you don't have any contact with a TV presenter. Yeah? I mean, just like generally speaking. Okay? Now, you won't want to miss this. Yeah, I think it's a TV presenter. Yeah, this is more, just like more formal, guys. Okay? It's worth watching. Yeah, both. Not formal, not informal, just like a very common expression. So both. I highly recommend it. TV presenter. Yeah. Yeah, just like your friend, I mean, doesn't say just like, I highly recommend to go to, and I just like very formal, okay? Now, it's well worth seeing, okay? Both. It's a must see. If you go there, you should go there. You must go there. Yeah, just like more formal, just like a TV press. You're like set by the TV presenter, okay? Okay, guys, now showing reservation. Sorry. It was okay. It was all right, I suppose. I suppose that's a friend. Okay, yeah, very, very informal. I wouldn't bother if I were you. A friend. Okay, yeah, just don't go there. I didn't think it was great. A friend as well. Yeah. You might like it if you have nothing else to do. Okay, you like both. If you enjoy it, you love both. It'll appeal to anyone who enjoys. Appeal, that's a very formal word. Okay, so yeah, a TV presenter might say that. I don't normally like, but okay, that's both. I would recommend it to people who, so both as well. Okay, ready, guys? Nice. Okay, guys. Okay, so I think we have done this, guys, in previous lessons. Okay, remember when we were just talking about reviews? Okay, it says exercise number 5 says, for each category below, write the names of one example that you would recommend and one that you wouldn't recommend. Okay, so in this case, you don't need to do this, guys. Okay, don't need to do this, but just like in, as an example, guys, for example, a book. So using one of these expressions, guys. Okay, so for example, you know what, guys? My favorite author is Haruki Murakami. Yeah, so and he has this book that is called Tokyo Blues, one of the coolest book I have ever read. Okay, so I think Tokyo Blues is worth reading because it's a book. Okay, yeah, and that's it. Okay, very, very easy. Okay, now, okay, guys, if you go to Mexico City, you have to go to the Azteca Stadium, okay, yeah, and what America playing there, okay? Yes, hey, okay, things like that, okay? No problem? Okay, guys, okay, let's go on.
This could be us. So back to what I was saying. This could be us.
Okay, guys, now, before we go to the writing skills part, we're going to wrap up this grammar. I think this is not complicated for you guys because you know this, you knew this beforehand as well. But the thing is that sometimes it's kind of confusing. But let's see, guys, we have reactive clauses, okay? And you know, okay, just like teacher Raul explained to you and teacher Josue explained to you this. Okay, so let's wrap up this and, just pay attention, guys, okay? So, we have relative clauses, guys. You know that we have two kind of relative clauses, okay? Defining relative clauses and non-defining relative clauses, guys, okay? And in this, we have to use this kind of connectors. Who, that, which, whose, where, etc. We have more. Okay, we have whose, to whom, etc. Okay, but let's focus on these ones. Okay, remember, we have defining relative clauses and non-defining relative clauses. Okay, yep. Okay, guys, now defining relative clauses, they are the sentences that give relevant information, and we cannot take out any piece of information. Okay, yeah, that's important. Oh. Okay, now, non-defining relative clauses are sentences that give extra information. Now, we use commas in here, and if we take out a piece of the sentence, okay, a piece of information, it's not important, guys, because the sentence is understandable, okay? Now, remember, we have the connectors, who for people, which for things, where for places, when for time, whose for possessions, okay? That's it. And remember that can replace who or can replace which, okay? So that is for things and for people, okay? The same here, guys, okay? No problem, okay? Yeah? Okay, now, let's see the features of each one, okay? Defining relative clauses, okay, they give essential information. No commas between the sentences. You can use that, yes, or you can omit the relative connector, okay, when it's not the subject, okay? We're going to that, okay, just in a minute, guys. Okay, now, non-defining relative clauses give extra information. We have to use commas, yeah. We cannot use that, and we shouldn't omit anything, guys, okay? So, okay, we have to use the connectors. We have to, it's a must in this part, in non-defining relative clauses, okay? Yep, okay. Okay, for example, we have these examples, guys. The woman who lives next door is a doctor, okay? The woman who lives next door is a doctor. Or I can say, the woman that lives next door is a doctor. Okay, guys, very, very important to understand these guys. Okay, why this is defining relative clause? Okay, this is a defining relative clause, guys, because if we take out this part, if we say the woman is a doctor, okay, so we have to ask, what woman, you know? Yes, that's why who lives next door, that's why this sentence here, it's vital, it's essential, yeah? No problem, yeah? Okay, now, one more example, guys. Okay, in this example, we can use who, or we can use that, or we can omit the connector. Why? Because both examples are defining relative clauses. We cannot take out anything. For example, guys, the woman who I wanted to see is away, or the woman that I wanted to see is away, or the woman I wanted to see is away. As you can see, guys, yes, we can use one of these three connectors. Oh, well, here is not a connector, it's like nothing. Okay, so you can use who or you can use that. Yeah? Okay, remember, these are defining. We cannot take out, we cannot get rid of anything, guys. Okay, good, nice, okay. Okay, now. Okay, look at this example. Susan, who works in that company, is such a well-qualified person. Yeah, in this case, guys, Susan, if we know Susan, okay, this sentence, who works in that company, okay, is not necessary. Okay, we are adding more information just to reinforce what we say about Susan. Susan, who works in that company, is such a well-qualified person. Now, what happens if I take out this? Susan is such a well-qualified person, okay? And nothing happens because this is just like extra information. As you know, it is separated by commas, and if we can get rid of it, nothing happens, okay? The sentence is understandable, right? Okay, good, next. Okay, remember, these are non-defining relative clauses. Okay, next example. Our college, which gives education in English, accepts Remember what is this term? Scholarship? Yes, when the government grants you a scholarship you ask for a scholarship to the government or to the school, that means that you shouldn't have to pay anything, okay? Because the requirement for a scholarship is for you to have a good average, okay? That's it, una beca. Remember scholarship, okay? Now, okay, just like going back, guys. If we take out which gives education in English, if we take out this y lo quitamos, nada pasa. ¿Por qué? Dice, our college accepts students with scholarship. Yeah, the sentence is understandable, guys, and nothing happens if I take out which gives education in English. This is just extra information that we are adding to the main sentence, which can be our college accepts students with scholarship. Yeah, okay. Okay, now guys, we have here relative clauses as sentence modifiers, okay? Which is just like another comment of this topic. It says, when a relative clause begins with which, we can use it to comment on the whole sentence. For example, they didn't bring any food, which is unusual since they always bring snacks. Okay, yes. Okay, so we are using this as well just to comment. We are just like adding more information. We have a comment that back up what we are saying, okay? Now, one more time, if we take out this, nothing happens. They didn't bring any food since they always bring snacks, okay? That's it, which is unusual. This is the new part, yeah? Okay, good. Okay, one more example. She called me at midnight, which was rude because she knows I work early mornings. Yeah, one more time. If we take out which was rude away, if we take away this, nothing happens. She called me at midnight because she knows I work early mornings. Now, yeah, okay, good. Okay, that's it, guys. Let me show you some other examples. It says, how do you reduce an adjective clause to an adjective phrase? For example, if there is to be, is, are, okay, I mean the verb to be, delete the to be and the relative pronoun, which is who, which, at, etc. For example, okay, look at this example. This is the same example. The car which is parked there is the director's car, yeah? Now, if we take out this, which is parked, okay, and we can omit this and just to say it just like this. The car parked there is the director's cars. Yeah, so we omitted the relative pronoun, which, and the verb to be. It's okay, which is the same. These are the same. Okay, now, if there is not to be, is, are, etc., delete the relative pronoun, who, which, that, and change the verb to ing form. Okay, for example, the man who escaped from the prison was a bank robber, okay? The man, which man? Okay, what man? The one who escaped from, okay? So the man who escaped from the prison was a bank robber, okay? And then, okay, we take out this and we have to switch verb in ing form and the result is this one. The man escaping from the prison was a bank robber, okay? Yeah. Okay, guys, that's it. Okay, now hopefully this is clearer for you guys. Okay, and that's it, guys. Okay, so hopefully we can do a review just like later on, guys. And hopefully you have learned a little bit more. You can maybe you clarify this in a better way, guys. Okay, and that's it. Okay, so keep on just like ahead. Spread it back. Okay, guys, now let's go to page number 115, guys, okay, which is this one. Okay, we're going to work on writing, guys, a little bit. And also, guys, we have the first question here. Okay, it says here, writing an email describing a place and its culture, okay? Now it says, we're going to work individually, obviously, because you're at home. It says, what are some of the cultural attractions in your area, town, or city? Which would you recommend to a visitor and why? Okay, guys. Okay, just like it comes to my mind really, really quickly, guys. For example, here in San Luis Potosí, in the capital city, we have some good attractions as well. For example, we have events in the Teatro de la Paz. We have a good plays. Maybe we have a good, I don't know, just like music events as well. Maybe if we have some museums here as well. For example, there in San Juan de Guadalupe, where we have one. Maybe we have another one in Aranzazú. Okay, that's it. And also we have El Museo de la Máscara, the Mask Museum, which is really, really incredible, guys. Obviously, those places are closed now because of the virus thing. But I think sooner or later they are going to open and we can visit them as well. And some of them have just like the virtual tour. Yeah, so maybe it's worth seeing, just like watching them or just like looking for them in internet and just try if they have a good website. Okay. Also, guys, if you are kind of sportive, we have the Tangamanga Park maybe. And if you are really adventurous and you would like to go just like further the capital city, maybe you can think about La Huasteca in the beautiful waterfalls that we have there in Tamasopo, Mecos, for example, there. Okay, so think about that, guys. Okay, now we are going to do exercise number 8. Okay, it says here, read an email on page 153 from Macarena, who lives in Valparaíso in Chile. What things does she recommend to her friend Aki about her city? Okay, so first of all, guys, first of all, okay, before we go to this, okay, let's go and know a little bit more about Valparaíso in Chile. Okay, guys, okay, so we have the continent, the American continent, guys. And as you can see, we have Chile here, just like next to Argentina, and we have there is Valparaíso. Okay, we have the capital city, which is Santiago de Chile here, and you can see here that we have Valparaíso, all this region here. Okay, remember this section is powered by Google Maps. Okay. Okay, we have Viña del Mar, and they have a very famous festival, Festival de Viña del Mar. Okay, just like there. Okay, here. All this area, guys, here, this is Valparaíso. Okay, yeah. Okay, and, yep, yeah. Okay, so, okay, Valparaíso, it's a very picturesque, yeah, very colorful town. As you can see, okay, the photograph we have here, okay, very, very nice. It's like a very, as I told you, picturesque town. Okay, look. Yes, look at this. Okay, it's very populated, as you can see, guys. Here, okay, nice. Okay, very nice. Okay, this is the most important port in Chile as well. Okay, and okay, we have this website that is called Stingy Nomads. Okay, what is stingy, guys? Stingy, remember, is not generous at all. Okay, that's the opposite. Okay, the opposite of generous, stingy, that's the opposite, guys. Okay. Okay, and it's here. Okay, 19 awesome things you do to do in Valparaíso in Chile, okay? And, okay, we have here the list. Discover street art, get lost in the narrow street, get inspiration in La Sebastián, admire fine art, walk the city, take a boat, okay? Yes. Chile on the beach, okay, that's here, right? An old trolley bus, okay, okay, that's it. Okay, okay, so the first one, okay, how to stay. Okay, we have some advertisements here. Okay, I don't know what is this about. Oh, this is cool, but no. Okay, for example, number one, discover street art. Okay, here you can go to this website, guys, And just if you are interested, you can learn more about Valparaíso. Okay, one more. Okay, it says, get lost in the narrow streets. Okay, that's it. Get inspiration in La Sebastián. Okay, that's the house of the most famous Chilean poet and writer Pablo Neruda. Okay, from Chile as well. Okay, admire fine art. Walk the city. Okay, we have a very nice picture here. Okay, not hot sale, sorry. Okay. Yeah, so we have many, many things to do in Valparaíso, okay? So let's go back to the reading. And okay, so let's go to page number 153, guys, please. 153. Okay. And on page 153, we have this email. Okay, remember, guys, we are trying to learn or to review how to write an email describing a place and its culture. Let me zoom it, guys. Okay, we have this one. Okay, yeah. Okay, so basically, I'm going to read the paragraph, guys, and I'm going to read, okay, while I'm reading this, I'm going to read the things that comment on this. For example, guys, it says, hi, aquí. Just look at the writing tips on page 151, okay, in a minute, about beginning and ending informal emails, okay. Now, I'm going to read this paragraph, okay. Thanks for your postcard. What a surprise, I never get postcards. Nara looks like a fun city, and it was great hearing your news. I'm glad everything is going well for you. I'm sorry this isn't a postcard, but you wanted me to tell you about Valparaíso, and I can tell you more in an email. Okay? Okay, I'm going to read this. In the first paragraph, respond to any recent communication you have received from the person you are writing to. So, okay. And here's the reason why this Macarena doesn't write a postcard, because a postcard is very short. Yeah, an email, she can describe more about Valparaíso in this case. Okay, next paragraph, guys. Okay, it says here, I guess what the city is most famous for is a museum dedicated to Pablo Neruda, who was a famous Chilean poet. The museum is okay, but unless you're a poetry fan, I wouldn't bother paying to go in. The views over the city are fantastic, though, and free, okay? So in this case, she wouldn't pay to go to the Pablo Neruda Museum. I think, I would love to go there, okay? So I would pay to go there, but I mean, different hobbies, I guess. Okay, it says here, order your main points about the place logically. Include at least 3 or 4 pieces of information. Okay, that's it. Now, next paragraph, it doesn't have any comment. It says, what I really love about the city is its location. It's so mountainous and next to the ocean. So I recommend spending a lot of time just exploring. I love taking the ascensores, which are like very small trains on the steep hills. It's also well known for the paintings that decorate the streets and buildings. There's color everywhere. Yes, I show you the pictures, guys. So yeah, obviously that's a colorful town, okay? Now, next paragraph. And finally, and it says here, use connectors to join ideas. And finally, you can't come to Valparaíso without spending a day at the beach. Our fishing harbor, La Caleta Portales, is a wonderful place to relax, but also to watch the fishermen and market traders. Okay, good. Okay, remember, guys, if you do not understand a word, okay, just keep on reading and see if you understand it, just like after that. But if you don't understand it, just go through, I mean, you are in a computer or in cell phone or whatever, so go to the Google site and that's it, and Google the word, okay? Now, anyway, I hope you get to visit me here one day so you can set it for yourself. Even better thought would be if I could come and see you in Japan. Best wishes, Macarena. So Aki is from Japan, Macarena is from Chile. Okay, it says, use the last paragraph to look ahead to future communication. Write back soon or a meeting. Okay, guys, as you can see, guys, okay, she's very smart. I mean, Macarena is very smart describing, in this case, Valparaíso, guys, okay? So if you need to read one more time, just read it, guys. Okay, now let's go back to page number 115. Okay. Okay. Okay, now we have exercise number 9. Remember that we had this grammar just like beforehand and also in different lessons, guys. Okay, just like previous lessons with teacher Raul and teacher Josue. Okay, relative clauses are good, are a good way of adding extra information. Read the email on page 153 again. Where could these relative clauses go in the email? Okay, and then, okay, if you go there in your book, okay, you don't need to just follow the video, it's okay. Okay, we have four examples. Which is why I think artists love the play so much, which is where I'm going later with some friends, which I got this morning, which I'm not, okay? As you can see, guys, okay? So, Macarena is using relative clauses on the email, okay? Good? Okay, just to mention that, guys. Okay, and then, okay, I'm going to read this, and I'm going to go deeper in a minute, guys. Okay, so paragraphing, guys. Okay, so why is important to make paragraphs while I'm writing? Okay, it's very important because I was telling you in some sessions in the classroom, guys, that for example, people from the US, from England, from Australia, from Canada, if they are writing an essay, okay, so they have this skill with them to make some paragraphs, guys. Okay, why is paragraphing important? I'm going to read for you and then I'm going deeper. It says, writing strategy. Paragraphing. Paragraphs are a group of sentences which share a common topic. They help the reader follow the text. Start a new paragraph when you change topics. Before you start writing anything, make notes. Then organize your notes into paragraphs. Finally, decide on the best order for the paragraphs. Okay, let me just like, I think I can close this. Okay, and then guys. Okay, I was telling you that the importance of paragraphing, it's really, really, really cool to know that. Because as for example, guys, if you are going to keep on studying or if you are going to present your certification exam, okay, it's important that when you write, the way we write in Spanish is a little bit different the way we write in English, guys, okay? So if you are doing an examination in English, okay, just like a certification, it's like FCE or CAAE or a different, or this exam, it's called IELTS, which is a very, very important one as well. Okay, this IELTS works to go to ask for a scholarship outside the country. Okay, but you have to write the way the professors or the teachers want you to write, okay? So I'm going to read in order for you to know the importance of this, okay? It says, the importance of paragraphs in IELTS writing. Okay, and the teacher who is writing this, it says, as an IELTS tutor, one of the biggest problem I see in students or candidates for a certification exam writing is a lack of or insufficient use of paragraphs, okay? Paragraphs are so important in writing. Good paragraphing helps a reader understand and enjoy your writing. Good ideas are not enough to write a good essay. They need to be organized so that they make sense. Okay, guys? So this is the importance of paragraphing. Okay, and the teacher goes on. I constantly tell my students, new idea, new paragraph. Keep one idea to one paragraph is the most basic rule of good paragraphing. If you find yourself moving into a new idea, stop and get ready to write a new paragraph. Okay, stop, just like a period, un puntito, or full stop, un punto y aparte. Okay, and then just like to write a new paragraph with a new idea. Okay, okay, finally, I'm going to read this. Okay, it says, in a paragraph, you might have several pieces of supporting evidence for the one idea. You might even have several points. If you do have several points, however, they must be related to the main idea or topic of the paragraph. In these points start to get too long, though. It's probably a good idea to give each point its own paragraph to discuss it further. You've got to constantly think about your reader and if they are going to feel like they're getting lost in the information. Okay. So, okay, this was taken from this website, okay, Best IELTS Online, okay, and they give us really, really good pieces of advice, okay, with this related to writing and reading and all that, okay? So, yes, guys, okay, so let me tell you that paragraphing is really, really important in when you write an essay. For example, guys, okay, this is going to be for homework, okay? Homework, guys, okay? Okay, antes de seguir, chicos, acuérdense que vamos a pedir un portfolio. El portfolio va a ser su workbook, guys, ¿sí? Yo después les digo qué ejercicios van a hacer. I'm going to ask for your workbook, guys. Y los writings de estos ejercicios de cada unidad. So, this is for homework, guys, okay? Just write this and later on, cuando sea que regresemos a clase, chicos, me van a dar su portfolio, sus workbooks, ¿ok? Y vamos a ver cómo vamos a evaluar este periodo. Así más o menos vamos a evaluar las clases, ¿ok? Bueno, dice aquí, ok. Dice, writing skill, paragraphing. The email on page 153 contains 5 paragraphs. Read the writing strategy box. What is the topic of each paragraph? ¿Ok? And then you have to say the topic, ¿ok? But, it's here. For example, paragraph 1 talks about the postcard that Aki sent. Okay, that's it. Okay, it says here, letter B. Okay, now that's it. Now, let's move to, this is the homework, guys, okay, to exercise number 11. It says, plan an email to a friend describing the place where you live here in San Luis Potosí. Include the usual sites as well as the alternative cultural attractions. Use your ideas from activity 7 to make notes and plan the paragraph, then write your email, okay? Okay, guys, homework, okay? This is the homework that I'm going to give you. Okay, you are going to write an email, okay? Just like that, okay? Here are the indications. But remember, on page number 153, you can, one more time, reread the email, and you are going to write an email just like that one, guys, okay? Obviously, think about San Luis Potosí, about usual sites, it says here, or cultural attractions we have here in the city, or maybe in the state, no problem. And you are going to write that email. Please, guys, focus on paragraphs, okay? One idea, one paragraph. That's very, very important, okay? Yes? Okay, guys, so you like keep it ready for, your essay, keep it ready, your email, keep it ready for the future. And that's it, guys. If you have questions, okay, just contact us in the CNA web page. And that's it, guys. Okay, hopefully you have liked this class. And see you next class. Okay, you know what, guys? Maybe next class we're going to do the workbook or something because we have only one unit left. And that's it, guys. Okay, I'm very happy that you can watch this video. And see you later, guys. Okay, Luigi out. Bye.